Great here. Welcome back to Factorio. Okay, so we finally have assembly machine 3s. Yay. These are nice. They have a crafting speed of 1.25 and a slightly larger energy consumption, but they're faster. That's the best part. So, what I want to do is I'm probably going to update everything, but in the time being, just out of curiosity. Yeah, they also get I think they get more module slots. I want to at least get the frame, my robot frame, upgraded. And I can make one right now for some reason. Not sure why. It's going to take me a while because I need the speed modules. And I'm crafting those by hand. I'm such a bad Factorio player. So, where's my wall? I've had this hole in my wall this entire time. No, I have not. Really? This looks bad. This looks bad too. Why do I not have power on this thing? Yay, more squirrely power. Okay, well, let's get a wall back up and running, shall we? Because apparently I deconstructed it. I'm going to do a little curly Q here. And we're going to get rid of this. And these right here. Good. Okay, so... Oh, no. Over here is where I deconstructed all that. So, yeah, I had that hole in that wall that entire time. Wow. And here I thought I had completely walled myself in. That was kind of scary. Okay. Good thing I came up here, huh? So, where was I? Right. Assembly machine 3. So let's get over here. Notice how the robots are getting a lot quicker. That's a good thing. Assembly machine 3. You, sir. Where are you? There. So now, this is going to be running faster and making more robots for my robot army. Wahaha. So, today, I wanted to upgrade that. I'm done. See ya, everybody! No. What I want to do is, I want to start pushing out further, I think. However, I have a biter base here, I've got a biter base over here. Let's see how far down my walls go. Yeah, my walls extend down to here. Yeah, I'm safe from these biter bases down here. So, for the time being, what I want to do... Steel plate, iron gears, and advanced circuits. I got steel plate, I've got iron gears, I got advanced circuits. So, do I need this here anymore? Yes, I do. That was silly of me to do that. Steel plate... Iron gears. Advanced circuits. Yeah, I'm going to have to bring it up separately. Okay. Well, for the time being, what we're going to do is we're going to push out the wall. In a cheap way. Let's get this extended out, like so. Okay. Let's take care of our research. I want logistics 3. This will give us blue belt, which is faster than red belt, requires lubricant to create. Which is why I want to eventually have the lubricant balanced. Actually, what I want to do is I want to get military 3 so I can get my combat shotgun. So let's get that taken care of. In the meantime, let's do our a pass on the guns. So we have guns here. Same setup here. And how far down can I get this to go? There. Okay. And of course, all of that is outside the logistics network, right? Right? Yes. And I don't want to push the logistics network out just yet. What I do want to do, however, is I want to grab these 5 gates and move them over to here, where they disappear to. Gates, there they are. Oh, only 4 gates? Oh, I guess it's only 4 gates. There we go. Okay. So, we can now free up this interior here. We're finally building stuff on the bus again. There we go. Okay. Oh, the other thing that I wanted to point out, which I haven't in a while. So if we go here to the modular armor, you'll notice that my personal roboports are max charged. The batteries now are draining first. That's why I'm able to just do all this robot stuff. And that's why I'm not rushing for my fusion reactor, because I'm finding that I'm doing okay just with this. And actually, you know what? I just realized. Let's get max ammo on that, and max shotgun shells. There we go. Okay. So, I want to automate the production of roboports. And I want to do that so I can actually push out using robots. There we go. So let's get our bus pushed out all the way. Military 3 is taken care of. Okay. I can do landmines. I've never done landmines before. I wonder what they do. Area of effect size 6, damage 40, explosion. Yeah. Ooh, I could get tanks. Excellent. Cannon shells, explosive cannon shells. I haven't even built a car and I can now do tanks, because I just run everywhere, I don't mind. Effect transmission. Beacons are something I want to get into eventually. Actually, what I want to do is I want to get my productivity module up and running. Okay. So, the bus is going to move over. Ooh, this is going to take forever. Okay, let's not do this. Okay, for the time being, let's just have our blue. So I want to have it here. Okay. So this is going to be, where are they? There it is. Roboports. Okay. Steel plate, advanced circuits, and gears. What's the ratio? 45 of each, so it really doesn't matter. Okay, so and we need this to come out like so. At least out to there. Look at the massive shadows here. Okay. iron gears. You know what? I'm going to bring up just one line of each. That's what I'm going to do. So here, here, because it's 45. And we will want our fast inserters. And I'll just do an output there into a passive provider chest, which I need to make more of. Yes, I should automate it. Oh, here we are under attack again. Okay. And this we're going to limit to 1 because of reasons. And in fact, we're actually going to limit it even further. And say that if you have RoboPorts greater than 50 in the network, anywhere in the network, less than 50, you can extract. I'm never going to have a ton of logistics of RoboPorts, but I do want a backlog of them, maybe, maybe not. No, let's make this even further, because I'm not going to have a ton of them. If you have more than 10 in the network, you're not allowed to extract. And since I've got that, I'll just get rid of this. Okay, so first we need iron gears. Let's make this easy. There's the iron gears. Okay, so now we need to get these up. Advanced circuits is next. So there we go. And you know what? I'm just going to make it easy on myself. There we go. I'm going to just do another splitter here. Like so. Okay. And yeah, let's call this off again. Okay. Now, let's look at our advanced circuit production, because we haven't actually seen this in a while. See how it's doing. We have our blue circuits. Fine. Advanced circuits are trucking along. These would be a good candidate for the yellow. In fact, now that I've got these going, it's working along. Okay, now that we've got this going, let's actually speed modules. What does it take to make speed modules? I need 5 advanced circuits and 5 electric circuits. Well, I've got advanced down here. Well, can I actually... I wonder, do these pick up off of the underground? Let's find out. Let's take half a stack. Yes, they will. Nice. Okay. So, speed modules. Here. Okay. And on the other side, I want to put productivity modules. And this is going to be another temporary setup. And the reason for that is because if I ever want to extend the blue circuits, I want to extend it south. But for the time being, I want to get these up and running. Oh, I didn't start up a new research. I want my efficiency modules, please and thank you. Okay. then these I am going to put into a passive provider chest, like so. And again, we'll limit these on the inserters themselves. Connect, if you have, these are the speed modules. If you have more than, say, 20 in the network, less than 20, you can extract. You, productivity, if you have less than 20, you can extract. And I realize that when I do it like that, the machines themselves are going to have a full stack in them. So that means over here, you know, it's waiting on circuits. Okay, so, yeah, I know there's going to be a full stack over here and a full stack everywhere else, but once the machine stacks up, that's going to be the end of it. So the good news is I have got speed modules. I also have productivity modules. So these increase energy consumption by 40%, but they reduce speed, but they also, every once in a while, you will get an additional unit out of it. You can't put productivity modules in final stages. So I can't... Here, I'll show you. Let's put that there. Okay. So if I come up here to the RoboPort, I can't put productivity modules in here. Where are they? See, because it's a final product. Can't do that. You can only use it on intermediary products. So, for example, batteries, I think, are considered an intermediary product, right? Let's find out. Yes. So if I have this in here, this will actually, after a certain amount of time, produce extra batteries. But I don't want to use these at the time being. Why are you not... You have red circuits right here. No, really, you have red circuits. Why are you not... Okay, these use blue. Let's just knock these out right away. Why are you not pulling out of... Can these not pull out of these? Didn't they originally? Yeah, there's red circuits. Wait, before I do that, let's do this. Why are you no worky? Whoops, did not mean to do that. Productivity modules. There we go. Okay, so... Advanced circuits. Why aren't you pick... Oh, because... Wow. Good one, Grade. Okay. So... Let's get the chest back down. Nope. I just realized I want the chest here. Okay. Passive provider chest. There we go. Okay. So clearly I messed up the circuit connected. If you have less than 20, you're allowed to extract. And you, circuit, blue... Less than 20, you're allowed to extract. Right? Okay. And then the reason that I have it on this here is so I could do another underground to go to the next layer. So, why are you not extracting? Why? I don't have more than 20 of these in the network, do I? Yeah, I have one in the logistics network. Why are you not extracting? Greater than doesn't extract. Less than it doesn't extract. Okay. This is more than frustrating. Yeah, this is a passive provider chest. Hold on. Oh, they're not in the network. Got it. Okay. That makes it a lot easier. Okay. So, let's set this up again. If you have less than 20, you're allowed to extract. If you have less than 20 of these, you're allowed to extract. There we go. Now let's run up here and grab our... RoboPorts. And I need to drop a RoboPort somewhere. And the optimal place is just outside the network. Or outside the walls, of course. So, let's have fun and actually place it outside the walls. There we go. And before I go any further, let's get power onto it. Let's get a light. And... walls. Where's my wall? There we go. And down here we'll actually put one of these there. Nope. Like so. There we go. Okay. Next research. This requires purple science packs. I don't want those, so let's knock the level 2 out of the way. Okay, so now that we're in the network, are you producing? No, because you need more red circuits, which is respectable. Okay. So let's grab all of the... Oh, wait. Let's put these back in, because I don't want... No. There we go. You, go away. Okay. Why? What? Why? I'm confused. Okay. So, we need much more red circuit production. So, let us get assembly machine 3s going. We don't have enough for a third one. So, where is our assembly machine 3s? There it is. Let's start on the bottom and go up. And these, now they're producing these a lot faster. And of course, that means that these are going to have to be ramped up as well. But baby steps. Baby steps all around. Okay, next thing that I want to do. I want to be able to push out. So, where's my next RoboPort going to land? My next RoboPort is out in the trees. There we go. Let's do the same thing here, just a quick wall all the way around it. There we go. How far out do these reach? Yeah, they're protecting the walls, so for the time being, that is decent. There we go. And again, let's just clear this out. And put down the four gate here. There we go. In fact, in my blueprint book, do I have... No, I don't. Okay, well. Do I have brick? Yes. Can I... If I do this, and I do a shift, does this actually... Yes, it does. Okay. So we're extended all the way out to here now. And I want... these. There. And there. And now that we've got a logistics network out this far, where's my secondary defenses? There, there. And let's actually put it on. Can I fit it on either side? No, I can't. So let's put it here and here. Okay. And I will now actually get rid of these and these. As this, the power should make it all the way around. Yeah, it does. In fact, I'm going to get rid of this one and, oh, direct connect there. And just have a medium pole pop up there. Okay. Oh, I ran a little bit long. Whoopsie. Well, let's get this started. Okay, so... from here, this is where I'm going to push out, is from this little extension right here. And that will have to be in the next video. Hope you enjoyed today's video. Have fun!